Congratulations to Homes on placing so many people.
What's the plan for the homeless who refuse placement?
So for host, for us, a refusal of placement at this moment does not mean that's a refusal forever. We will continue to work with individuals as they continue to, you know, as we're building trust and we're building relationships to find them the right intervention. We can't just place people, you know, necessarily into any intervention. It has to work for their needs. It has to work for their, you know, where they're at with their job or whatever it might be. But we will continue to engage with somebody. And just because it's a no right now doesn't mean it'll become a yes in a year. For some people, they're ready in the moment to kind of take that next step or enter the journey of finding housing. Other people, we've had to engage 12, 13, 20 times before we're able to get to even understanding what their name is and what their needs are. So nobody's journey is totally linear, and nobody is the same. It's all respecting the individualized journey for the person and continuing to engage as they allow us to.
Is the current lawsuit with homeless advocacy group restricting or preventing this encampment or police in dealing with the issue? Example, people coming into neighborhoods and disturbing homeowners.
That's a tough question, and thank you for asking it. So I wouldn't say that the current or the pending lawsuit has stopped us from moving forward with addressing this encampment. We've had to change our approach. It used to be that we were able to simply offer a shelter bed and document that we had enough shelter beds available for individuals before we moved forward with the encampment. That approach has changed a bit, and so we've had to expand what services we're offering in terms of making sure that we can accommodate persons with disabilities. And now with the vehicle encampment, we're looking at what's an appropriate